JQF, coverage guided property based testing in Java, and Roland is going to give the presentation.
Thank you. Hi everyone, so my name is Roland Pate. I'm a student at UC Berkeley. And what we're trying to do is borrow some of the ideas that we've seen from the field of coverage guided fuzz testing, which has become really popular, at least in the security community, and apply it to some ideas that are more popular in conventional software testing, such as property-based testing. So let me give you an example of what property testing sort of looks like. Let's say you wanted to test a class from the Apache Commons, which is like a try data structure. So a try is nothing but a set of key value pairs. And you can actually construct a new try, in this case, a Patricia try, which is a specific implementation of tries, from an input map, so like a JDK, Java util map object. And the try is just going to have the same keys and same values as the input map. And you want to test some properties about this map, about this try. So how do you do it? So a property test is nothing but a JUnit style method, but it takes some parameters. In this case, we are giving it two parameters, an input map, in this case a map from strings to integers, and another string which is some key. And the property test can have some preconditions. So you can say, well, let's assume that this key that you're providing actually exists in this map. And now if I construct a new try from this map, I should expect that the try also contains the same key, right? So this is a reasonable contract that that every try should satisfy. So this should be true for all input maps and all input keys, that if the key exists in the map, then the key should also exist in the try that is constructed from that map. So how do you verify this property? So property testing, which is popularized by tools like QuickCheck, simply say, let's call this function many, many times with randomly generated maps and keys and see if you get any assertion violations, as long as the assumptions are true. And this is in fact written in a Java port of QuickCheck, which does exactly this. So how do we generate these maps and keys? Well, we generate them randomly, essentially. So if you want to generate a map, well, the JDK provides many different implementations of maps. So which one do we choose? Well, just pick one at random. Well, the hash map has some entries. How many entries to pick? We'll just pick a random number. So let's say we pick two, so we need to create two keys and two values. Again, just generate them randomly. You can see where this is going. So this is like one input. You run the test. In this case, the assumption doesn't hold true. You run into some other random inputs. You run into some other random inputs, and keep doing this many, many times. In fact, you can tell QuickCheck that run this 1,000,000 times. You hit the assumption at least sometimes, and you can run this using just say a command like maven test. And you run this 1,000,000 times, and then JUnit QuickCheck says, well, no, none of the assertions were violated. All the tests pass. And Apache Commons is released. So everyone's happy, right? Well, that's where we come in. So we're like the party poopers. So our tool is called JQF, and it says, well, let's take a look at this property test, and we're going to take the property test exactly as you wrote it. The only thing we're going to change is the annotation. So instead of add property, we're going to say add fuzz. Everything else is the same code, the same assumptions, the same inputs. And now what JQF does is says, well, you generated these inputs randomly, but you didn't get any feedback from the program as to whether these inputs were good or not. So instead of generating making these choices at random, we're going to search using some well-known techniques like coverage-guided fuzzing, using some sort of mutations. So we remembered what choices we've made in the past. We make some changes to those choices. We get feedback from the program in the form of, say, code coverage. And we perform sort of this evolutionary research to find better choices for these inputs. So the idea, in many cases, is to maximize code coverage. So if you have, in this case, you're testing the class Patricia try, it has some branches, you want some input that, let's say, executes this branch, some input that executes the other branch, and you basically want to generate inputs that execute all of these different branches. And you would also like inputs that probably meet these assumptions. So we also want to satisfy these assumptions with a high probability. And that's exactly what JQF does. So it takes the same property test, and now the only difference is that the command is Maven, so we have a Maven plugin, so you just say Maven JQF fuzz, and you run this, and in just 5 seconds, you get, on average, in 5 seconds, you get like an assertion violation, and you get an input that meets this assumption, but does not meet, satisfy the assertion at the end. And here's an example of such an input. It's a hash map with two entries, it has two keys. The keys only differ in a null byte. So in Java, null bytes don't actually terminate strings. And the other key is also one of these two strings. And if, you know, this is a real weird corner case, but if this is what the input looks like, the assertion fails. And it's actually a bug in the implementation of Patricia Try. It's almost impossible to generate such an input using just quick check. Random test generation is not going to give you such a corner case, but JQF can do this in just a few seconds. And it's actually funny that this example, this bug that we found, was accidentally discovered while we tried to find a short example to write in the paper. So this was not actually one of the original motivations, but it's a cute example and we found this bug. Well, I didn't really tell you anything about what the algorithm is, which does all this search-based testing. So if you're interested in the actual algorithm, we have an ISSTA paper that I'm going to be talking about on Friday. It's called Semantic Fuzzing with Zest. So the Zest is the algorithm, and we do semantic fuzzing, which means we try to generate inputs that are biased towards satisfying semantic invariants, which are given by these assumed statements. But JQF is sort of broader than that. It's a sort of a platform, and you can run many different fuzzing algorithms. So another algorithm that we have in JQF, it's called PerFuzz. We actually presented this at ISTA last year, and it can help you generate inputs that exercise worst-case complexity and maybe find some performance bugs in your test. So you can use quick check style property tests and find performance bugs. JQF also runs other fuzzing tools. You can run AFL, which is a popular fuzzing tool, as an external sort of plugin. And you can also write your own fuzzer very easily and plug it into JQF. So you can think of JQF as a modular framework for producing ISTA papers. So how do you create your own fuzzer? Well, JQF has this interface called a guidance, so you provide your own guidance. And you essentially have to say, well, you provide how to generate an input, so get input gives you the new input. Handle result is what's called when a test finishes executions. So you get an idea if the test was successful or not. And you can also listen to trace events. The trace events are code coverage events, like a branch has been taken or a function has been called. So JQF does all the heavy lifting for you. It implements JVM bytecode instrumentation. It integrates with quick check and quick check generators. All you have to do is sort of provide some implementations for these methods, which gives you a fuzzing algorithm. And JQF has been useful in finding new bugs in many sort of widely used open source projects. You might have heard of some of these projects, Maven and Google Clojure Compiler. What's interesting is that many of these bugs were actually not found by us. These were found by random people on the internet who downloaded JQF and used it to find bugs and insecurity vulnerabilities. So it's pretty cool. So some of the users of JQF other than us, Netflix is using JQF to test their message security layer. This is a tweet from the VP of Apache Tika who found bugs and sent us a tweet. So I'm more bugs than Twitter, by the way. And this is another thing that I found recently. So there's a Swiss cybersecurity conference, and there's a person named Tobias Ospelt, who I've never met before, who's giving a talk on how to find Java bugs using JQF. So other people have found it useful. I hope you guys will also. It's open source. So you can check it out on GitHub, download it, and try it. And I'll also be there with the posters, and I can give you a live demo of JQF if you're interested. Thank you.
Thank you very much. So again, in order to try to save get a little bit of time, I would ask the next speaker to get ready. I'd have some time for a quick clarification question. Although I do remind you that right after this session, there is the poster session, so there's plenty of time to talk to all the speakers, and in this case also during the technical track. Okay. So, thank you.